can try and read my lyrics off of this paper before I lay them. But you won't take the sting out these words before I say them.
This American rapper, record producer, and actor is no stranger to controversy.
I don't give a damn what you think.
Welcome to WatchMojo.com, and today we're taking a look at the life and career of Eminem.
Hi, my name is...
Born Marshall Bruce Mathers III on October 17, 1972, in St. Joseph, Missouri, Eminem was an only child raised by a single mother. His interest in hip-hop was sparked at the age of 14 when he first heard the Beastie Boys album, License to Ill. After moving to Detroit, he started participating in freestyle battles under the name Eminem. Though he dropped out of school by age 17, Eminem's rapping skills had already managed to gain him approval in the underground hip-hop scene.
Didn't have anything, you know, got evicted from the house I was staying at, and really reached a point where I just hit rock bottom, so I stopped giving a f***, and it seemed like as soon as I stopped giving a f***, other people started giving a f***.
Eminem released his debut record, Infinite, in 1996. Despite this advance in his career, the artist fought a number of personal problems, including drug and alcohol addictions. These obstacles led to a suicide attempt shortly after the album's release, and his development of an alter ego, Slim Shady, as a way to cope. By 1998, Eminem began working with rap heavyweight Dr. Dre, and even earned himself a record deal with Dre's label, Aftermath Entertainment.
Dr. Dre said,
Slim Shady, you a basic. Watch your face red, man, you wasted.
His first album on the label, the Slim Shady LP, was released in 1999, and eventually became one of the year's most popular CDs. With Eminem and Dr. Dre pairing up for a number of tracks, the album's recording sessions marked the beginning of a fruitful friendship between the two, as they would team up on many hit singles in years to come.
Nowadays everybody wanna talk like they got something to say, but nothing comes out when they move their lips, just a bunch of gibberish. That's what they forgot about Dre.
Eminem's lyrical content is often a source of scrutiny, and both the Slim Shady LP and the next year's the Marshall Mathers LP were no exceptions. While both albums were successful, they each included songs about murder and violence.
You selfish, hope you burn in hell for this.
The song Stan off Marshall Mathers was his biggest hit and recounted the story of a crazed fan who kills himself and his pregnant girlfriend. Eminem has been involved with a number of other projects outside his rap career. In 1999, he created his own label called Shady Records. He then signed Obie Trice and D12, which was a collective formed in 1996 that included him and five other Detroit rappers. The success of D12's 2001 debut, Devil's Night, has been attributed to Eminem's international fame at that time. The group followed up that record with the 2004 album, D12 World. November 2002 saw Eminem play the lead in the semi-autobiographical movie, 8 Mile. After appearing in the movie, his track, Lose Yourself, won an Academy Award for Best Original Song. The rapper has since done several voice acting roles and performed cameos on television and in films. Eminem's first break from music and touring came in August 2005, when he canceled the European leg of his Encore tour. The singer subsequently announced he was undergoing treatment at a drug rehab center for dependency on sleep medication. December of that year had Aftermath releasing a greatest hits compilation called Curtain Call, The Hits. However, after that release, Eminem confirmed he was uncertain about the future of his musical career. To the satisfaction of fans, by September 2008, Interscope Records announced a new Eminem album was in the works.
My shoes, just to see what it's like to be me. I'll be you, next to each shoes, just to see what it'd be like to.
Relapse, his first album of original material in 5 years, was out by May 2009. Just over a year later, in June 2010, his seventh record, Recovery, was released.
Just gonna stand there and hear me cry. That's alright, because I love the way you lie.
Eminem's story is not complete without mentioning the many personal troubles he has had. Issues with substance abuse, arrests and lawsuits, as well as twice marrying and divorcing his high school sweetheart, Kim Scott, are among some of his most notable problems.
It was my decision to get clean. I did it for me. Admittedly, I probably did it subliminally for you.
However, having overcome many of these obstacles, Eminem continues to be praised by MCs for his rapping techniques and is one of the most successful men in hip-hop today.
Walk this road together through the storm, whatever weather.